Nokia was once the world leader in mobile phones, and for a lot of Chinese internet users, it was one of the first affordable mobile phones that they had. But in today's mobile market, it is instead dominated by the likes of Samsung and Apple, and the downtrodden Finnish company, first established in 1865, saw itself bought out by tech giant Microsoft for as little as $7 billion. Now, Microsoft has said that its purchase of Nokia is to strengthen its own position in the market. The latest Nokia series, the Lumia, already uses Microsoft's Windows system, but only about 7 million phones sold in the second quarter of this year uses Microsoft's system, while 31 million phones uses Apple's iOS and 187 million phones uses Android. Now, Weibo's reaction to the buyout was mostly that of surprise. Now, a lot of people felt that $7 billion was a very cheap bargain for a company as well established as Nokia. Now, a lot of Chinese internet users had fond memories of Nokia and hope that the company can make a comeback. And now let's take a look at some of their comments to this story.
What a bargain! Even Motorola was sold at more than $10 billion. No matter what, Microsoft is a bigger company than Nokia. It's a good thing for Nokia's staff because they won't get laid off. Instead, they are now Microsoft staff. I really hope Nokia can stage a comeback with Microsoft's help. I will remember Nokia fondly. Nokia was a company that produced miracles during its golden era. I remember when owning a Nokia phone was the dream of all the students, and I was one of them. Unfortunately, by the time I can afford it, Nokia had lost its former glory. Stephen Ellip is the best business spy in history. He dragged Nokia down from a $200 billion company into a $7.2 billion company. Now Nokia is in the hand of his old boss. What a great scheme! This would be great for his future plans of becoming Microsoft CEO.
Now, while Apple is still seen by many as a status symbol with around 5% market share, and Samsung is the biggest smartphone vendor in China with around a 20% market share, Chinese brands are also rather successful in the domestic market. Brands such as Huawei and Lenovo are in the third and fourth position in terms of market share. But what a lot of people outside of China do not know are the 400 smaller domestic brands that's been making some amazing progress. According to an article from the New York Times, Coolpad sells their phones for under $100 and was able to grab a 10% market share briefly in the first quarter of this year, ahead of some of the big names like Lenovo and Apple.